Of course, darling.
There we go. Now, get to the main computer terminal and enter the security sequence.
Mainframe, as soon as Scarlet enters...
G.I. Joe, always so gullible.
I wish I could have gotten the rest of you here, but sci-fi interrupted my plans. No bother, though. We put together another trap to spring on them.
Attention, G.I. Joe! Your puny resistance is over! There are no more places to hide!
They'll never win. Even with G.I. Joe down for the count, the people of this world won't bow to Cobra.
Oh, but they will! Cobra first seized control of the world's power and technology. Now, we will seize control of its population!
This bell dates back to the Kofun period of ancient Japan. It is said to have been crafted from a fallen star that landed in the region centuries before. The metal, when molded in this form, resonates at a frequency unlike anything on this planet. One simple tap of the material. While this device only has a range of a few feet, anyone who hears this frequency temporarily has all semblance of free will negated from their mind. Or permanently, if they are continually exposed to the sound. That is, unless they have the proper protection. Once this property was discovered in ancient Japan, a group of rogue nobles built a mold for a larger, more powerful version. But alas, the metal in my hand was all that existed on this planet. Well, until recently. General, please join your friends and await further instructions.
Urashikage knew the type of power that could be wielded if the planned device was ever completed. They attempted to hide the mold parts away over the centuries and across the globe. But they could not hide them from Cobra. You had one job.
Don't worry, he cannot have gotten far.
For your own good, it better be that way. Rats, seize this usurper at once! What? Why are these bats attacking us?
How about a taste of your own troops, Cobra Commander?
Unbelievable.
When I catch you, I'll show you what this facility is really used for, Joe!
If you catch me, snake!
Oh, yes! We are getting swarmed! If we deactivate the bat pods, we can lower their numbers! Where is he? He must have used another door.
But those are supposed to be locked!
Seems that he's getting help from someone else.
There he is! Wait! Where did he come from? What is the meaning of this? Open the doors!
Whoops. Must have slipped my finger.
You! You dare mock Cobra Commander?
You fool! Stop wasting time and help me blow up the door already!
You better go back to your hiding holes if you know what's good for you. You do!
Cut this!
Ready, why won't you die?
Oh, yes!
Oh, yeah!
Thank you. A gift from me to you!
Ready for beautiful destruction!
Oh yeah! Won't happen, buddy.
I would keep my distance if I were you.
You waste Cut your breath, this! Joe! I know how empty your threats are!
Oh, I wouldn't call them empty.
Ready for beautiful destruction!
Lovely. I'll take it. Oh, no.
That's right. Keep your distance, or it all goes boom.
What? What is he blabbering about? Speak up, fool!
This building, like all the others, has a self-destruct protocol in case the facility is compromised. Robot must have grabbed it when we lost him. We need to stop the detonation sequence, or we'll lose everything.
That's right, Red Kyle. Checkmate. Roadblock. You got 10 minutes to get out before it's boom time.
For beautiful destruction!
The main engine should be blocked! Where's he going?
By the looks of it, he's moving to the cargo lift.
Cannot allow that! I won't have him jeopardize my ascension!
Our Cobra ascension!
You're just looking for trouble.
Thank you.
Experience with a toad, Cobra.
Drop the device, and maybe we can make this short.
Cobra! Catch this!
Yo, Joe!
Ready for beautiful destruction.
This is our way, Roadblock. Hold tight. Roadblock, you only have 5 minutes. Leg it.
It's
from me to you!
Ready for beautiful destruction!
Oh yeah! Now get him!
Wait! Grab the detonation device first!
Just a quick nap.
He's getting away!
Oh, you fool! He could have ended everything just now! Everything!
Because of your incompetence, Roadblock has escaped! Don't you ever cross me again, Baroness!